everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to go through the switch case statement. And switch case statement is a multi-way conditional statement generalizing the if-else statement. You can use also else-if, but switch is more convenient. And the form of switch case statement is switch, and inside the parentheses it is a expression which is a condition, and it is an expression, it's not exactly a condition. And inside the switch you are going to use case. Case express one express, then you use statements and use break. Case another expression, and you are going to use a statement break, and so on. The last expression, statements break, and you are ending the switch with default and an statement. I have a typical example, and it is I have defined integers, and I have a character. C is equal get char from the prompt, the get character from the prompt, and we are going to use switch C, that character, and we are going to use case if it is lowercase a, then we increment I with 1. If it is b, if c is lowercase b, we don't do anything. But if C is capital letter of B or uppercase B, we increment J with 1. Otherwise, else or otherwise, it's default. We are going to increment Co with 1. Then you see that we can have a case without any expression. And so notice that the body of the switch statement is a compound statement. This will be so in all but the most degenerate situation. The controlling expression in the parentheses following the keyword switch must be going to be valid. Now I am going to put all those codes inside our program, and I am going to use the tab for all of them, and I am going to use tab for all of them, and something is initialize them because we are going to increment, and otherwise the program is going to get a default value which we don't want it. We compile it and everything's okay. Now we run the program, and I'm going to put a gap B, and we are seeing that if we have A increment with 1, I with 1, and if it is B do nothing, if it is capital B we are going to increment it, and else it must be incremented G 7 8. It should be incremented, but it doesn't. And it is correct. No I, no that one, and default is K plus plus, and it is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. It should be 8, but if I use the I B oh. A B okay, doesn't accept. Why it jumps out? Okay. A B I. Okay, the first is correct, and the rest of them it doesn't read. 1A. Okay, the reason that it doesn't accept an string because we only read a one character, and we are going to switch in this case, and it is going to take that one, increment with one, and it is break, which breaks the switch, and it's going to print out the values. If I use while CHR is not equal new line, then you can use that switch. we are going to compile it, and we are going to write AIBCBF. Now it is correct. 1A, 1B, and the other one, 1, 2, 3, is none of big B or little B. But it seems that case B, we haven't left anything, but we have seen the case B, and it is going to increment each time these ones. And if I don't have it, it's going to be IAFBK. Now it is correct. It is A1A, 1B, and three other characters. Okay, and it is not so much in this, and it was all in for switch and case, and we are going to go through more examples, and see you on next tutorial.